Still continuing our tour of the 254. We find ourselves here at Grandpa Records, a name in the industry, especially when it comes to making some of the biggest hits that we have experienced, not only in Kenya, but also across the border in Uganda. Introducing himself, we have none other than the founder himself, Mr. Heavyweight, joining us here on the show. Rafika, great to have you here, man.
Man, thank you. Karibu Kenya sana, bana.
Thank you very much. Or should I say asante sana?
Asante sana, because when you come to Kenya, we give you a package.
Indeed. And today, we find out about the package that is Grandpa Records. And later on in the show, we'll also find out about the big concert that we came for yesterday. And that is tomorrow's Leaders Festival that happened. We'll find out about that in the show. But first, let's take you back in time with Rafika Heavyweight. And we find out, first of all, about the founding of Grandpa Records. When did this come to life?
That was 2009. Now we are about to celebrate 10 years in the music industry.
When is that going to be?
That will be in December. Yeah. We'll have a big event, yeah. And I'm sure we'll definitely invite you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Looking forward to that. I'm sure you will have a number of the artists, if not all of the artists that have graced Grandpa Records over the years, coming over for that one.
Definitely. Even our friends from Kenya, from Uganda, from Tanzania.
Yeah.
We're going to have a big number.
Speaking about the artists that have stuck with Grandpa Records, let's start from the beginning. When this vision started, who did it start with? Which artists did you start with?
Actually, the vision started with me. Mm-hmm. And after that, I think our first success story was Amelina from Tusker Project M4.
Yes.
Yeah, Amelina was our first success story. And from Amelina, we started working with different artists, DNA, Esther Wahome, Waire, Nazizi, Sauti Sol. We've worked with almost everyone.
Yeah.
Yes.
Moving over, looking at the last nearly 10 years, some special moments that have stood out for you. I know there must be quite a number.
I can say the first one is when we won Winton House of Music Awards for the best record label in East Africa.
Why was that special?
Because that was like the first time we got an award representing East Africa.
Yeah.
You know, like win any best record label in East Africa, not just Kenya. So to me, that was very special.
Yeah.
Yes.
That came about because of, were you putting out a particular hits that particular season?
Actually, it came at around a time whereby across East Africa, we had the most hits. Actually, almost in almost every chart.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Any other special moments?
Oh, there are so many. I have to line them up.
Lining them up like the awards that we saw on the inside are quite a number over the years. After all of these, is there a place you want to see the records going, Grandpa Records going in the next couple of years, now that you're turning 10?
Yeah. Actually, one thing about me myself, I don't like being in a comfort zone.
Yeah.
And if you ask me, in East Africa right now, I feel like I'm being in a comfort zone.
Yeah.
So actually, I want to broaden, to widen my audience. Right now we are working with artists from West and South Africa also.
Yeah.
Yes.
Any in particular if you can talk about it?
Yeah, there's some, but they're supposed to remain exclusive as for now.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially there's one from Nigeria which will be launching next month.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Looking at yesterday's Tomorrow's Leaders Festival that happened, that we will be showing, giving you footage of here on Backstage Pass. Tell us a little bit about that particular festival.
I think Tomorrow Leaders Festival was a brilliant idea.
Even
the first time I heard about it, I was like, this is a masterpiece.
Telling us about the artists who were there. Which artists were there?
I think apart from Morgan Heritage, who are the organizers and founders of that,
yeah.
Alain, there was Diamond, there was Chameleon, there was Waire, Yemi Alade, there was Juakali.
Yeah,
quite a number of artists.
You were saying when you heard about it the first time?
Actually, it was a brilliant idea.
Yeah.
And you know, Morgan Heritage is a big deal in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
And I think in the whole of the world. Mm-hmm. Actually, I can say they are the most successful reggae band after UB40 in the history of the world.
Interestingly, Morgan Heritage actually have found their heritage here in Kenya and have been living here for a while, right?
Yeah, Morgan Heritage, they've been around. They've been around for quite some time. I'm sure there's a lot they're doing in Kenya.
Yeah.
Yes.
Going back to the concert, did it pan out the way you had envisioned it at first?
I'm sorry to say, but the concert was a flop.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting that because I also went there as a fan.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a big fan of Morgan Heritage.
Yeah.
And first of all, I think wrong choice of venue contributed to that.
My dad. And which venue is that?
Kasarani. Kasarani, it's known for flop events. That one, it's in the record.
Can a place actually have a curse like that?
Yes. No. First of all, the place is like 25 kilometers from the city center, first of all.
Yeah.
And the neighborhood is, yeah, and the neighborhood is all, it's not that safe.
Yeah.
So there's so many things that's contributed to that. The neighborhood, the venue, the weather, and I think the lineup of the artist.
Is this a case of what the English would call too many cooks spoil the broth?
I don't think so. You see, in Kenya, I think Kenya, reggae is so huge in Kenya,
yeah,
like any other country, mm-hmm, more than any other country in Africa. Yeah. Reggae is big in Kenya. Mm-hmm. Kenyans really love reggae.
Yeah.
But the moment you are advertising a reggae concert and you line up pop artists, it won't work. I know the reggae fans in Kenya.
Yeah.
They are religious followers when it comes to reggae.
When you say top artists, you mean top artists who are not reggae artists?
Yes. Reggae fans, that doesn't go down well with them. I know it for sure. Yeah. Believe me, Morgan Heritage on their own, they can even fill 30,000 people in Kenya.
Yeah.
Yes, I know that. They have that capacity.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow. Looking at yesterday's event also, things you learned from it, seeing as you're trying to pull off something yourself with quite a number of artists together, any things you learned from it?
Of course, it's just the usual, the right choice of venue, the target audience, and the surrounding. Just opposite of what I said.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's true. Actually, most of those actually do hold for our events also in Kampala. Some events are absolutely fine, but depending on the place they've actually decided to put them, sometimes they're too far away and completely inaccessible, which kind of makes it very hard for the average person to attend. Thank you very much for having us here at Grandpa Records.
Thank you so much for your time.
A quick shout out to the Ugandan people on what we can expect from you in the next couple of months, possibly. Any fresh new music, any surprises?
Ugandans, you know, these are my people. Yeah. And every time I go around the clubs, around the streets, that I get to hear songs.
Yeah.
And I can always say Uganda is one of our strongest bases when it comes to fan base.
Yeah.
Yes, so from next month, the government will be back.
You heard it from the man himself, joining us here on the one and only exclusive on Backstage Pass. We're here in Nairobi, Kenya, with none other than the founder of Grandpa Records, the man himself, Mr. Heavyweight. Thank you very much.